Rachel, I go to Northside, and this is called Jazz Fest. We were still little. We showed our love for each other in little ways. Instead of taking each other out to fancy restaurants, we sat on logs by the river and in the back of train cars. We dined on little treats like chocolate-covered almonds that I stole from Starbucks and chocolate chip cookies that Jenny let you buy with her employee discount in Potbelly. They cost 40 cents. 40 cents is less than a fifth of what train rides cost in the summer, unless there's no CTA worker sitting inside the station that day. Much less than a fifth cost, unless you have a purse and the bottle sitting in the store aren't all behind the counter. On your birthday in August, I gave you a five-part present. One, MASH season 2 on DVD that I bought from the exchange in Wicker Park. Two, a handwritten card that I didn't buy from anywhere. Three, raspberries that I bought from the jewel on Lincoln. Four, a handle of Smirnoff that I didn't buy from the jewel on Lincoln. And five, your favorite one of my t-shirts that I bought from a young couple's yard sale for $1. When your parents were at Jazz Fest at the end of summer, you had me over to your house so we could pretend it was ours. You boiled ravioli and played a jazz album that I'd never heard before. I brought a bottle of Merlot. Is it okay if we use regular glasses? I don't want my parents to notice that I moved the wine ones. Sipping wine from skinny water glasses made food taste sour on our tongues. We gave up and brought the bottle upstairs, hands wrapped around cold and warm necks. We gave up on drinking from glasses. Hands tipped bottles back as usual, creating angles which increased proportionally to our laughter. Other times, we held hands across the kitchen table like grown-ups do in movies and kicked each other under it like middle schoolers afraid to make eye contact. We sat at this table with your family some nights when they made us come downstairs. I poked Jenny under it whenever your parents weren't paying attention. We've sat at this kitchen table at 3 a.m. when we came inside from our pretend house of a tent we set up in your backyard. We ate some of your sister's birthday cake, washed it down in some of your dad's Maker's Mark, and we pretended like the tent in your backyard was our home, and it felt like it was on the night it rained so hard that we didn't care about waking up your parents. Because summer rain made better insulation than fabric walls ever could. Because summer was drawing to a close, we still weren't ready to give it up. I'm still not ready to give it up, even though it's starting to snow sometimes now. Both of our sisters left for college this year. When your parents saw me lounging on your couch in the living room, TV glow dancing on both of our faces, they liked to joke about how you and I were basically sisters. They said this around the kitchen table at dinner one night before your sister moved out. She almost choked on her food because her room shares a wall with yours, and I'd spent four nights here that week. I miss turning nights into mornings with you, watching curtains turn blue with sunrise as your eyes bluer with morning air. I miss when our lives were completely intertwined instead of only crossing paths